coming to your writing, or you are interested in poetry too. Now, these days, the difference between prose and poetry, it's become prosaic, or I would say poetry has lost its meter, or somewhere we don't have a rhyme or reason for poetry these days. What do you think about the present-day poetry when compared to the classics?
I will tell you, you are a Tamil-speaking person from Palghat. So you would know that many Malayalis believe that if they drag out the Malayalam vowel, it becomes Tamil. So anything you drag out the Malayalam, you drag it out. And then you think it's Tamil, but it is not. So like that, today poetry has really taken a challenge. It is, some people still write beautiful poetry, but the elegance of even medieval or even recent, only now it has become so bad. But maybe even about 50 years back, beautiful poetry, and now, and they had not only the imagery of expression, imagery of choice of words, the rhyme, the meter, so many things. When the poetry just does not mean something, some words strung together, and the less comprehensive, if you cannot understand, better, because then you can lend yourself to interpretation. Gatha, the poetry lends itself to interpretation. That makes it very nice. You can write whatever you want. But I have really seen poetry which I cannot understand at all. Some works, you should not say that, of course, because everyone who writes, it is their own creativity and their own creation. So I suppose it is not ethical to pass a judgment. I am not passing a judgment on any of the poetic offerings that have been produced or are being produced nowadays. I am only saying my opinion, that is all. That my preference. For me, I would like to understand what I am reading. You may interpret. Now, Shakespeare also had interpretations. But at least, I mean, there was something very solid to interpret. You are not interpreting on, something which is very vague or nebulous. You are not. And then there is no rhyme. Tagore also had blank verses. Tagore also had, and Tagore could get away with it because he was Tagore. But nowadays people write blank verses which look very much like prose. And then the fashion to write just one word in one book, in one page, just one word. Just one word. Sometimes it is not even a word. It is a sound. The word which represents a sound. You can interpret. That means it could. It shows the poet's multi-dimensional emotions. That ayo means it could be happiness. It could be ecstasy. It could be anguish. It could be anger. You can go on interpreting whatever you want. You can, which they might not even thought even half of it, isn't it? So and. All sorts of, I at one particular meeting where poetry was the subject matter and different poets were submitting their poems. One gentleman submitted a poem. I could not understand even one word of it. It appears it's called a computer poem. He gave the poem to all of us. I can't understand what is it, just some squiggles, some marks and squiggles. I can't understand. I said, so I asked the person sitting next to me, can you understand? He said, no, I can't. With some relief. Then he says, this is a computer poem, which when you understand, it's wonderful. When you understand is the operative word. And if you understand is another operative one. And whether you want to understand is another thing. Whether you have the time and energy to fathom it out is another. But anyway, it gives the man satisfaction. Otherwise, would he have produced it at a poetry conference? I prefer poetry which should be beautiful, which should have the essence of poetry, the imagery of poetry, the charm of poetry, whether it is sad or happy or melancholy, that's a different thing.
Now, another aspect, when I walked into the palace, I see Here Comes Papa, Ravi Verma's painting, and I see paintings. Now, these days, art also has lost what it is for having people who have really made a mark in this world with their realistic paintings. These days, art also has gone to a level. Your views on art too, please.
Again, I'm not disparaging anybody's ideas of what they should do or what is art. I'm an old-fashioned person. So I cannot understand modern art. I'm not saying it is bad. I'm not saying it should not be done. All I'm saying is I cannot understand it. That's all. I have seen certain things. I don't know what it means. There is a base, some color, and at the end of it, there is some other mark. Now, it is supposed to transmit some great spiritual secret. I don't know. Maybe. Finally, out of despair, you give up everything. These sort of things, or some metal pieces bent together, it's a sculpture. Then there was a painting, a big painting, in an European restaurant. Nearly half the wall it took. So all sorts of blobs of colors, God alone knows what is it. On top of that, one area, it's a sort of white, something which looks like white paint. The whiteners you have nowadays, the whitener. But that's not a whitener. Everybody appreciates, what a wonderful painting. The owner of the painting was highly delighted. He told one of my relations who had gone there, I have not seen it. He said, you know what this is? My children, they just messed up on the paper. And then not only that, one of them was playing with the toothpaste, and the toothpaste jumped out. So he wanted to take it off, so the toothpaste got smeared all over. That is a why. That's a masterpiece.
Coming to a totally different question, where we want to know about Padmanabha Swami Temple from you, what you would like to say. Because currently what they are looking at is, everyone talks about gold, values, treasures. But more than that, there is a culture, there is a tradition which happens to date back to many, many years back. And it's still those who want to understand that feeling, or probably during the solstice, the movement of the sun, the architecture, or probably the Vinayaka who is on the wall, which is date back to the construction. It is. True. Yeah, so we would like to know about as princess who wrote about the temple, we would like to know what is the right way, or which is the right way to take when you're looking at Lord's temple, Padmanabha Swami temple.
All this while, you have been asking me questions. Now I'm going to ask you a counter question. You asked me about the Sri Padmanabha Swami temple. I'm asking you a question. How long do you have? Do you have two minutes? Do you have 2 months? Do you have 6 months? What's your time schedule? Then I will reply.
I would be happy for a 6 month schedule. But I would, again, look at the constraint of the time. I would say, we would like to know as precious as a diamond, as compact.
I will give you in 2 minutes. You have 2 minutes?
Yes.
Of something which cannot be condensed, which cannot be compressed, which cannot be made small, but which is anandamajnanam avarnaniyam. Vidamsham vibham nirmalam nirvikalpam nirīham nirākāram omkāra gamyam gunādīdam avyaktam egam duriyam. You see, but I will try. If 12 saligramas are worshipped together in one confine over a period of time, ritualistically, and saligrama is the fundamental form of Vishnu, like linga of a Shiva and chakra of a Devi, 12 saligramas worshipped ritualistically, Vaishnava worship, over a period of time, collectively they gain the potency of one Mahakshetra. in the Sri Padmanabha Swami temple in Thiruvananthapuram. 12,008 saligramas are held within a confine, coated with Katu Sharkara Yogam. It is not gold, it is not silver, it is not gems. Highly complicated Ayurvedic amalgam and other natural ingredients, with the 12,008 saligramas inside, and worshipped with highly complex ritualistic worship. Highly complex. They do sometimes what one day they do what many other temples do in 1 month. So, over a period of time. So, the Padmanabha Swami Mula Vigraha holds within it the potency of 1,000 Mahakshetras. 12 Saligramas, 1 Mahakshetra. 12,000, 1,000 Mahakshetras. 8 comes as a bonus. Okay. That is the answer. But then there are so many things connected with the Padmanabha Swami temple, whether it is the spiritual aspect, whether it is a symbolic aspect, whether it is a cultural aspect, whether it is a quasi-religious aspect, whether it is architectural, art, sculpture, historic aspect, all these things. Are there all enclosed, encompassed within those four walls where history does not sleep, but history reigns supreme. And he, Sri Padmanabha Swami, he is Shantam, Shanta Swarupan. At the same time, he is Nityananda, Paramananda, Brahmananda, Atmananda, Chinmayananda, Sampurnananda Swarupam, Padmanabha. To talk about him in a very short time, we cannot do justice to it. It is not possible. But I can tell you, reverting to the beginning of the interview, when you spoke of passion, I will perhaps conclude by quoting a line from Bhakti Manjari, authored by Maharaja Swati Tirunal in Sanskrit. Actually, I will say the four lines, where he is bringing in the imagery, romantic imagery, Indian romantic imagery, like the lotus and the bees, the chakwara bird and the clouds, and the moon and the bird, that bird, I forget his name. Anyway, those things are the mango, when the honey, the bees, so all the romantic imagery, part of it, of course, he is trying to bring into it. And it goes like this: I cannot sing, I do not know how to sing. Because I've been talking so much these days, my throat also, my voice is like that of very harsh, grating voice. But I will say the sloka. Ambho deshviha chataka valiriva prodbhulla padmakare Hamsanam nikaro yatha himakare yadvat chakora vraja makandeshu madhau yatha pikatati pushpeshu bringo yatha swamin swamin Mamakamanasam viharatam Tvayeva nityam hare. That is the Swamin. Mamakamanasam viharatam. My mind is not just immersing itself in you. It is not just becoming one in you, leikyala, viharikikana. It is my mind, my heart, in exaltation, exhilaration, intoxication. It is there at your feet. That's all.
We, more than thanking you, on behalf of the viewers, more than thanking you, it's a blessing. And we actually would take every word of yours as a guidance. And I'm sure those who are watching, those who have been to Padmanabha Swami Temple and those who have been considering as an abode because it is Vaikuntha itself. So for all, from on behalf of all those people, I would like to seek your blessing rather than thanking you.
I am nobody to bless. I am only somebody to pray along with you, with all of you, that may peace come on earth. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu maitrim bhajade sarvajananam patmanabha.